Hey guys, welcome back to the 12 Days of Christmas. Today is day 9 and we are talking about emotional self-care. What emotional self-care is, bringing awareness to recognizing and identifying your feelings that you may have about something. Once you recognize and identify those feelings, moving forward and honoring those feelings. The reason why you want to grow and practice emotional self-care is that you want to prevent being frustrated, experiencing people fatigue, feeling overwhelmed, or even feeling burnt out. So as it pertains to being overwhelmed, practical things that you can definitely do is that once you feel overwhelmed about something, inviting someone else to come in and help you in whatever task that you've been delegated to kind of help alleviate that stress. Have somebody come in and help you, or whether it be communicating with your supervisor, like, hey, you're putting so many tasks on me, advocating for yourself as far as what your needs are to make this not as difficult for you. Because what you don't want to do is suppress how you're feeling and just hope and think that it's going to go away. Because the more and more you start to do that, the more you're taking things on. And the next thing you know, you just kind of like blow up at the wrong person 9 times out of 10. So you want to take note as soon as you start to feel some type of way about something, or if you feel tired or overwhelmed, and just advocating for yourself and bringing attention to that. Sometimes you even can just use a support system, a best friend, or just a colleague, or your therapist. Something else that you can do when you're starting to feel overwhelmed is to be able to say no. Like, it's okay to say no sometimes. You don't have to take everything that's taking your way and carry the world on your shoulder because you feel like if you don't do it, nobody else is gonna do it. Because, I mean, it sucks to say this, but if you are working for a job and you can't do something, or, you know, if you end up leaving, or God forbid you die, or you have some type of like accident that causes you to not be able to do the job the way you were doing it, they're gonna find somebody else to do it. So don't kill yourself for a job when you're kind of like replaceable. I know that Beyonce said you're irreplaceable, but you're replaceable. So yeah, be okay with saying no. Along with being able to say no, you want to make sure that you're able to create healthy boundaries and then honoring those boundaries so that I don't go on a bandwagon of saying no to everything and everyone. I can create certain boundaries.
Okay, because of the things that are required of me and always being around people at work and then coming home to a bunch of other people and then having friends that want to hang out on Friday nights from like 7 p.m. to like 10 p.m. is like my me time, and I'm going to respect and honor those boundaries. And if anybody wants to hang out with me or spend time with me in that window, I'm going to have to say no.
So that you can have your time and moment for peace of mind to start practicing some mindfulness and mental health care and maybe even physical health care and just getting some sleep. Again, this is just an example, not necessarily your exact situation. Please feel free to take what I'm saying, reflect, and apply it to your specific life. So that's all that I have for day 9. Please make sure you come back
tomorrow, I love ya. Tomorrow, you're only a day away.
See you next time.